It's true, but when you're with someone for a really long time, and a lot of you probably know this, you go through a lot of the big ticket arguments, and if you manage to stay together after them, the arguments that ensue after those become very weird. Because you've done all the big ticket arguing, right? So now when we get into big arguments, like for example, the other day we got in a huge fight over how our dog would talk if he could. That argument is at on the same level of, you cheated on me from back in the day, right? And then you have the Groundhog Day arguments that just, they're the little ones that happen, and it's almost like you have to cycle through them and get them over with before you continue with your day. So now they happen so often that my husband and I take them for each of us. Like one of us will do both roles. So, for example, the other night we're going to our friend's place for dinner, and I get in the car and my husband says to me, "Did you remember to lock the front door?" And I was all, "Okay, I got this, honey. Just don't worry about it. Let me do it." And then, "Did you remember to lock the front door?" Yeah, I'm an adult human being. I know how to leave my house. Don't take that tone with me. What tone? That tone. We don't have to be married. I don't know why we are. Oh, yeah? Yeah, well, you're a fucking asshole. Well, you're a fucking asshole. Well, you're a fucking idiot. You're an idiot. Fuck you. Fuck you. Silence, silence, silence. I'm so sorry I called you a fucking asshole. You're not a fucking idiot. I love you so bad. I love you too. We're going to stay together forever. Yes, we are. But can we just turn around and go home? Because I can't remember whether I locked the front door or not. Really important to me. And then scene, and then I did lock the front door, and we go out and have a good time. So that's just, you know, that's just how it goes in these situations. And I, okay, so